required. All right. So carbon, what is the symbol for carbon?
C.
Yes. To be more specific, yes, capital C. Just a sec. Carbon is C. And how many protons, neutrons, electrons, like what's the composition of carbon?
Six protons, six neutrons, and six electrons.
So, isme se, what is the atomic number of carbon?
Six.
The mass number?
12.
Okay. What sort of a element is carbon? Like what type of element is it?
Non-metal.
Very nice. So carbon is a non-metal. Iska matlab, have you guys seen carbon in your real life? Like what does it look like? What does it exist as?
Covalent bond.
Toh, it is a type of bond. Now I'm talking about elemental carbon. So agar pure carbon dikhaya, so what would you expect to see? Like what would it look
black.
Like?
Black.
Diamond.
Coal.
Black. Blackish and grayish color, pink color.
Very good. So pretty much all of you have covered everything to do like with elemental carbon. Some of you have said diamond. Some of you have said it is exists as coal, absolutely. Blackish color. So ye black color ka carbon ko kya bolte? What is it called? The carbon that is there in
graphite?
Yes. So graphite. So these are like different forms of carbon that it exists as. Okay. So it's the same element, the exact same thing, carbon, which is C. It's just different ways that it exists as. You have diamond, you have graphite. Coal, yes, coal, soot. This is not like pure carbon. Like, yeah, I would say about 98-99% carbon hoga, but it's mixed with a little bit of impurities. Apart from these two, like diamond is a main thing, graphite is a main thing. And there's a third thing, it's called Buckminster fullerene. So all of these are different ways of carbon only. Mansi is saying ash contains carbon. Absolutely. Again, ash is not 100% pure. It has carbon. It would have like some carbon-based compounds. It would have some other, you know, elements and compounds also. But yeah, ash does contain carbon. Yeah.
Ma'am, is the last one pure carbon or is it like?
This is pure carbon. This is like one of the, just like how diamond is purely carbon, graphite is purely carbon. This is also purely carbon. One of the ways that carbon exists as. Okay. So all of these are different solids. Like carbon always exists in the form of solid at room temperature. So all of these are solids, just different ways. Accordingly, unke properties different hote. Buckminster fullerene is isolated more recently. Abhi 1900s mein kuch hua tha. This is the most recent one that was discovered. But diamond and carbon graphite have been around for a long time. And everyone knows about diamond and graphite. Like a lot of research has been done. We use diamond and graphite also for like different things. So if it is the same element, ye sare differences kyun aa rahe? Where is it coming from? So
structure.
Absolutely. Correct. Condition matlab, because of the conditions of how they are formed, that affects the structure. So the basic difference is in the structure. Structure matlab, abhi all these are solids, right? And what do you know about solids? Like solids ka property kya hai? Like how are
tightly packed.
And the molecules are tightly packed.
Correct. Molecules are tightly packed. But in all the cases, molecules are tightly packed. But how they are tightly packed differs between diamond, graphite, and Buckminster fullerene. So that's where the difference comes from. So let's look at the structure in each of the cases. So just to give you an idea, this is the structure of diamond. So what you see here, you guys able to see the screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Yeah. To understand it, think of, so whatever gray lines you guys are able to see, no? Those are the single bonds between the atoms. So har ek point of intersection jo hai, like this point, this point, this point, this point, wahan pe you have the atoms of carbon. Okay, so if I take any one point of intersection, like for example, if I take this point of intersection, so this carbon is bonded, one bond is over here, one bond is over here, one bond is over here, and there is a fourth bond iske piche yahan se jo aa raha hai. Theek hai? So each carbon atom is bonded to four other carbon atoms. Ye sare covalent bond hi hai. Okay, so I'll rotate it so that you guys have a better view. Oh, huh. So here you can see this one. Look at this one. This particular. Agar ek carbon atom idhar hai, so it's bonded to four other. So this is one carbon atom. Yahan se yahan tak dusra hai. Yahan se yahan tak teesra hai. And yahan se yahan tak is the fourth carbon atom. Now, in turn, each of these are again bonded to four carbon atoms. This is bonded to our original carbon. Fir the second one is over here. Third one yahan pe piche ja raha hai. And the fourth one is over here. Okay. So, all these individual carbon atoms are tightly bonded to like each other. Like each carbon atom bonded to four other carbon atoms. Aur ye sare bonds hai covalent bonds. Okay, so structure of diamond, how it exists is, you have a carbon atom. So each of these carbon atom is covalently bonded to four other carbon atoms. Now these four carbon atoms are again covalently bonded to four more carbon atoms. Now this is again covalently bonded to four more carbon atoms. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now this is again covalently bonded to four more carbon atoms. Okay, so that way all of them are packed tightly in one structure. So if it is packed in this way, where each of the carbon atom is bonded to four other carbon atoms, then the result that you get is the structure of diamond. Okay, so you guys are able to visualize, like, samajh mein aa raha hai structure of, like, how do you get diamond?
Yeah.
Okay, so this is diamond. So each carbon atom is covalently bonded to four other carbon atoms in tight covalent bonds. Tight, so like each, because it's all rigid structure, any carbon atom will not be able to move. So that is why, like, that is where the hardness of diamond comes from. Like, koi bhi bond ko rotate nahi kar sakte, because imagine, like, if I want to rotate, like, this bond, it means that I have to shift the position of either this carbon or this carbon. Abhi, these two are fixed because they are bonded to, like, other carbon atoms. So unko aasani se rotate nahi kar sakte, unko aasani se cut nahi kar sakte. So that gives rise to the hardness of diamond. That makes diamond like one of the hardest substances on earth. Okay. Now, let's look at the other thing. Wait. So this is the structure of diamond. Let's look at the structure of graphite. Oh yeah, let's see diamond. Okay, this is diamond. This is graphite. So do you see the difference immediately graphite mein kya ho raha hai? So graphite may, so graphite is made up of individual layers like this. So if you take, pick one layer and see what is happening in that layer. So I'll look at the top view. So har ek layer mein, so you have like a honeycomb kind of a structure. You have hexagons here. So each of these is a carbon atom bonded to just three more carbon atoms. Now this is again bonded to three carbon atoms. This is bonded to one, two, three carbon atoms. Now this carbon atom again bonded to three other carbon atoms. Okay. So that way graphite may, it is made up of like a honeycomb kind of structure. Like you have hexagonal ring structure. That's what you call them technically. So it kind of looks like this. Okay. Now, carbon.
Man, but doesn't carbon need four electrons?
That's what I was about to say. So carbon ka valency hai four, right? It has four electrons. It is capable of forming four bonds. So what is that fourth electron doing? So for that, I'll just rotate the structure. So it is made up of multiple layers, right? Now between these two layers, So the carbon from upper ka layer, there is one electron free. Carbon from niche ka layer, one electron free. So the each of these layers kind of forms like a loose bond between them. So this is not a covalent bond. It's just loosely bonded to each other. Like within each layer, the hexagonal structure jo hai. So there's three covalent bonds. And the fourth bond, basically, it's not exactly, not even a bond. So the fourth layer or fourth layer, like the force that holds the layers together. So that is held together by something called van der Waals forces. Okay. So within each layer, yahan pe, like six ring structure jo hai, that is being like the bonds between these carbon atoms are covalent bonds. And the fourth electron is like free to move between the layers. And each of these layers is held together by something called van der Waals forces. And because that fourth electron is loosely bonded, it's not tightly bonded as in a covalent bond, it's just loosely bonded like between the layers. That is the reason graphite is able to conduct electricity. Ek extra electron hai, so you put it between a potential difference, those electrons flow, and flowing of electrons is your electricity. That's why graphite is able to conduct electricity. But diamond does not conduct electricity. Other forms of carbon don't conduct electricity. So that is the main difference. And because you have layers, like graphite may, you have individual layers of carbon, right? So that is why you're able to use it in a pencil. So what happens when you're writing on paper with a pencil is you're depositing like a few layers of graphite. Your pencil lead is made of graphite. So when you write, I'm depositing one or, you know, a few layers of graphite, is it? It's not a single layer, it is more than that. But when I write, I'm depositing like three, four of these graphite layers. Okay. So that's another property of graphite. So if you contrast the structures of diamond and graphite, let's go back to sleep. Diamond mein kya ho raha hai? The structure is extremely rigid. Like each carbon atom is bonded to four other carbon atoms. Nothing can move. Everything is fixed, which makes diamond like extremely hard. Graphite is a completely different story. graphite is made up of individual layers, and the force between these layers is pretty weak. And graphite may, each carbon atom is bonded to just three other carbon atoms, which leaves the fourth electron relatively free. So it's not like tightly bound in a covalent bond, it's just held loosely between the layers. So the layers are held together by van der Waals forces, and because you have that fourth electron which is relatively free, graphite is able to conduct electricity. And because of that free electron, you have some properties of metals. Just say graphite is lustrous. There's that shine that you see for graphite. Graphite may, what else? Like conduction is another thing. And like graphite is also softer, much softer, because you can break these layers easily. So you can like cut
the pencil tip. They also break into the loose layer.
Yeah. Yeah. When you write, you're depositing one layer of graphite. And that's why you're able to sharpen a pencil easily, you know? Like even with a nail, I can just like, if I do this, I have like a small layer of graphite on my nail. So it's like very, it's not strong at all. It's pretty soft. And because it is soft and slippery, graphite is also used as a lubricant. Yeah, so like you use graphite to reduce friction. Like it's like kind of like how oil is used in cycle chain, how grease is used. So you use graphite as a lubricant to make things slippery, smoother. Okay, and you have the third form of carbon, which is Buckminster fullerene. This is again completely different way that carbon exists. So Buckminster fullerene is one single molecule which is made up of 60 atoms of carbon. So it's also called C60, sometimes written as C60, like both ways. Basically denotes that there are 60 atoms of carbon that are arranged, like the kind of bonding that they have between them. It's like a ball that you see here, like a football shaped thing. So you have hexagonal rings and pentagonal rings alternating. So this is Buckminster fullerene. And if you have to, like, if you want to see in reality how Buckminster fullerene exists, it is isolated in liquid state in a test tube. And I think it's got like a purplish color, like a slight purplish hue to it. Yeah. This is Buckminster fullerene. Manzi is asking, what is it used for? Again, it's discovered pretty recently, like 1960s, may I think, 1950s, 60s, quite recently. So it's usually used as a solvent. Agar kuch reaction karna hai, to some reactions you do it in water. Agar water mein dissolve nahi ho rahe sare reagents, organic chahiye, to like Buckminster fullerene C60 is used as a solvent for that. It's mainly in like laboratories and all, like everyday life mein zyada use nahi hai iska. Like you don't come across it easily. Ananya is asking, does this have the same properties of diamond? No, it's not hard. Like you have individual molecules, right? Ye to, like it's not exactly like one solid chunk. It's not a crystal. It exists in molecules. So mainly it's pretty like you see it in like, it has a low melting point. You can melt it into a liquid. Puneet is asking, how did they discover this? The story behind the discovery, I'm not sure. So it's not something you would find in nature. Like if you're trying to, if you are processing carbon, again, I don't know a lot about Buckminster fullerene. I have not done the research into this. But yeah, somebody was isolating carbon. The way they were isolating carbon, is at a specific temperature and pressure, you distill it and carbon settles into this kind of structure, like in those conditions. So on further analysis, ki iska structure kya hai, iska, you know, like what is the whole deal with this? He found that iska structure is in the shape of a ball. So he called it. So Buckminster fullerene was, iska name is called Buckminster fullerene because around the same time, there's an architect jiska naam hai Buckminster Fuller. Buckminster Fuller. Okay, so this is an architect who designed a dome, like buildings ke upar, ceiling pe dome, in a similar shape. So that this kind of shape, like that dome, is called a geodesic dome. And because ye molecule ka structure bhi thoda, it looks kind of like that, it's pretty similar to that. That's why in the honor of the architect, here this particular allotrope, like this form of carbon, is named Buckminster fullerene. Abhi ye naam lamba hai na? So the shorthand for this is, call it C60. They're also called Bucky balls. Kyunki it's like a ball kind of a structure. Yeah. These are like some fun facts. The how behind it, I'm not familiar with. Wo thoda dekhke, if it's an interesting story, I'll share it with you guys. But yeah, geodesic dome, yeah, you can see this is the shape, a dome kind of structure. So if these points of intersections, you know, if you placed carbon at certain points here, then it's kind of similar to Buckminster fullerene ka structure, like that carbon atom molecule ka structure. That's why it's called Buckminster fullerene. Okay, let's see what it looks like. So structure hai. What it looks like. Again, like this particular allotrope was mainly, you know, since it was discovered recently in this format, the structure is the main thing. So as I told you, it's not, you don't get it in like the natural, this thing. It was isolated in a laboratory. So it's kind of difficult to find a lot of information about it. Wikipedia should definitely have solid state mein, this is what it looks like, crystals. There you go. Like the crystalline structure is, this is what it kind of looks like. Buckminster fullerene. Manzi, yeah, it looks like a football, definitely. That's why they're called like Bucky balls. Yeah. Elena is talking about graphene. Good question. So Elena asked, is graphene an allotrope of carbon? Not exactly. So graphene is a form of carbon. So I'll tell you what graphene is. So you have, like, this is the structure of graphite, right? So what scientists did was, they were trying to find like the strongest structure, like they were trying to find some material which is like pretty strong, you know, something that's pretty strong but still flexible. Strong matlab, it shouldn't be like a sheet of metal that you can't bend or anything, but it should be like flexible, so you can use it for like bulletproof vests, or you can use it as a covering, or you know, lots of uses hote hai if you have like a strong thin material. So one of the things that they considered was graphite se kuch nikal sakte kya. So graphite, I told you, exists in the form of layers, right? So that's what your pencil does. So when you write on something with a pencil, it kind of, you deposit like a layer of graphite here. Like the more I do this, like more graphite I'm putting here. Now this consists of, like if you're looking at it at an atomic scale, even like a single line like this is still going to have like a few hundred layers. Okay. So what scientists did is, out of graphite, they tried to extract like just single digit number of layers of graphite. So that extremely thin sheet, like a few, you know, two or three layers of carbon that you get from graphite. So that extremely thin sheet is called graphene. So that is graphene. So it's not directly like an allotrope of carbon. Technically it's not, but it's like derivative of graphite. So graphite, graphene are the same things. Just that, you know, like graphite is your naturally occurring like proper form. Aur usme se ek single layer nikal ke rakha hai, like that's graphene. Theek hai. So where did you hear of it, Alina, about graphene?
Ma'am, actually, sometime back, I was seeing a video on the internet and it was titled as the most incredible substance people have ever found and everything. That's why I clicked on the video and then I remembered it now when we were learning about graphite.
Yeah. Very closely related. It is one of the strongest materials in the world. And that's exactly the purpose why people are trying to, you know, create like a proper usable way for graphene instead of just having like a tiny bit in the lab. So like you need an easy way to create it, a cost effective way to create it, and be able to create like a large area at the same time. So a lot of research is going into that. Graphene is one area of research. People are also looking into carbon nanotubes. So carbon nanotubes, you take Buckminster fullerene, but instead of like ball shaped, if you were to create tube shaped stuff. So these are also like extremely strong. So they can be used to make like fibers and cables and ropes and things like that. Strong ropes that will not break. So this is another form. Yeah, this is like a next, like if you guys are interested in chemistry, going into research, discovering like new useful materials and all, this is like an area you can consider. So yeah, all of these are still under research. People have just figured out ki ye aise ho sakta hai, or you know, these are the properties. But still a lot of work is to be done in terms of how can you make it usable. Like strong hair, but you need that length and it needs to be stable and easy way of preparing it. So all of those other things you need to look at. Okay. So graphene, carbon nanotubes, all of that fall under that. And then yeah, it has a pipe-like structure. But imagine like this, these are all individual atoms, right? So atom se chota, to like you'll have to start sending single molecules. But yeah, so that's why it looks like a tube, but because of its strong structure, it will find uses as a really strong rope, like fiber, just say nylon strings or those sort of thing, that sort of a thing. Yeah. So that's, yeah. But coming back to this, like the main forms, like, all the others are derivative of two main forms, which are diamond and graphite. Okay. These are like the two main allotropes of carbon. Jiska structure, function, wo sab like properly discuss kar sakte. Okay. So just to summarize it all, so we have diamond and we have graphite. So diamond ka structure like how can you describe the structure of diamond? So each carbon atom is bonded to how many other carbon atoms?
Four.
Four.
And what sort of bonds are there?
Covalent.
Covalent
bond. Absolutely. Single covalent bond, if you have to be more detailed. But yeah. So four other carbon atoms in single covalent bonds. And yes, Ananya has sent rigid. Yes, diamond ka structure is like you have a network of all these. This is how the network is formed and it is extremely rigid. So in contrast, if you look at graphite, graphite ke case mein, each carbon atom is bonded to how many other carbon atoms in covalent?
Three.
So bonded to three other carbon atoms with single covalent bonds. So graphite may you have, so another thing that keywords you can remember is diamond may the shape, like the structure, like the shape of how the carbon atom is bonded to four other carbon atoms. This is called a tetrahedral structure. So tetrahedron, like pyramid, cube, cuboid jaise, tetrahedron is a 3D structure. So tetrahedron ka structure is essentially pyramid jaisa hi hai, except it's a triangular base ka pyramid. So if the base is a triangle and upar ek point hai, and then you have like the sides like this, that is a tetrahedron. Okay, so this structure is called tetrahedron. So simple to remember. Tetra meaning four. So like tetravalent, tetra is four. So it has like four vertices. Okay, so that's why it's tetrahedron. Now, how is it related to structure of diamond is, if I have a carbon atom placed in the center of the tetrahedron, then the shape that it forms with the four other carbon atoms are the points of a tetrahedron. So, ek idhar, ek idhar, ek idhar, or ek piche. So, the four bonds kind of look like this. I want to show it 3D way. So agar center mein ek carbon atom hai, to it kind of looks like this. Ek upar and three more are there downwards. So if my hand is the central carbon atom, this is kind of the shape what it looks like. So if I join all of these four points, no? I'll get like base triangular hoga and upper they're joining at a single point. So it's like exactly like a pyramid, just that base instead of a square, you get a triangle. So this is what a tetrahedron is. Roughly. So yeah. So three bonds essay in the form of a triangle and one is on top. So symmetrical shape. Okay. So yeah. So diamond may the shape of, you know, like how the four carbon atoms are bonded is in the shape of a tetrahedral. So you say they are tetrahedrally bonded to each other, or you can say they're bonded to four other carbon atoms with single covalent bonds in a tetrahedral structure. So you can call it like that. So tetrahedral structure. And graphite may, what sort of structure does it form? Like in what shape do you find the bonding? Like carbon atom bonded to three other sheets,
layers and sheets.
Individual layers.
Correct. So layers of like har ek layer mein what sort of shape do you find? So layers
beehive are, like
yes beehive ka wo shape ko kya bolte hain mathematically
honey ko
hexagon
yes so hexagonal rings so you say it's a hexagonal ring structure yeah so if you had to see it this is what it looks like so I take a tiny bit of it. You can see here. So if I take this carbon atom, bonded to three other. If I take this carbon atom, bonded to 1, 2, 3. This is bonded to 1, 2, and 3. Like we say, the layer will, the sheet will continue on. Yeah. Anyway, so it's each layer. Consists of hexagonal ring structure. So main thing is you start at single atom. Each carbon atom is bonded to three other carbon atoms, single covalent bond. Mein. This bonding, it takes the shape of, you know, hexagonal ring structure. And all of these rings are arranged in like flat layers. And how are the layers held together?
Weak forces
by the
so
one extra one
while the
weak van der Waals forces so it's van der Waal W-A-A-L so it's he's like a European scientist Dutch I think yeah in that general region Scandinavian region it's van der Waals forces So let me know. So
can we, in place of rigid for graphite, should we say brittle?
And not brittle. Graphite in place of rigid, it's basically because of layers, it is soft and slippery. So diamond, you can call it hard. Where diamond is hard, graphite is soft and slippery. In this case, opposite of rigid, nothing. Actually, these layers are held by weak forces. That's why the layers can like slip against each other. That's why graphite is soft and slippery. Yahan pe nothing can move. It's pretty rigid. That gives rise to diamond ka hardness. Yeah. Let me know when you guys have noted down the thing. Mansi, yeah. So the properties, like yahan pe ab tak jo bhi discuss kiya, it's the description of the structure. So once you guys are done noting this, we'll talk about the properties, like the conduction and all of that stuff. Okay. Anirban has mentioned ki likh liya. So let me know when you guys have written. Ananya has done. Meet done. See Aditya. Okay. Navika is also done. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8 people done so far. So whatever I've written in like different color, that's like, if you want, you can note it down for your understanding. But the main points related to diamond or graphite ka structure is all in black. So I'll just put it over here. Differences matlab with respect to the structure. So okay, Deshna, Abhishek, Sara also done. 11 people. Ishita is done. 12. Jaden, yeah, 13. Oh, new emoticons, okay. Tanisha, Ananya, card. Yeah. So when we talk about the properties, I'll mention the importance like rigid versus hard, you all that thing. Yeah. So who is left? Vasudha, Snehal, Ritwik, Ryan, Neil, Dhruv, and Aditya Mundra. Divi also has not mentioned. Dhruv is done. Okay. Aditya, okay.
We have to draw the diagram, right? Both the diagrams in blue.
Yeah, that's what. Like the structure ka diagram is up to you, because drawing, I know that it's not very simple and straightforward. If it's helping you understand, draw it. But if it's like more complicated to draw and if it's wasting your time, let it be. Like there's always reference images, textbook mein hai, internet pe hoga, chapter notes mein hoga, so it'll help you with that. Yeah. What's up, guys? Like Vasudha, Ryan, Divya.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Note kiya. Like, how much time will you guys take?
Ma'am, done.
Done. To batana chahiye na. Okay. ठीक है, सो नाउ अभी स्ट्रक्चर डिस्कस किया, नाउ वील डिस्कस द डिफरेंस इन द प्रॉपर्टीज और यूजेस, लाइक प्रॉपर्टीज विल बी रिलेटेड टू यूजेस, सो वील लुक एट दैट पार्ट ऑफ इट. ठीक है, सो देयर इज डायमंड एंड देयर इज ग्रेफाइट. ओके, द मेन थिंग इज बिकॉज ऑफ द स्ट्रक्चर. सो डायमंड के रिजिड स्ट्रक्चर की वजह से दैट गिव्स डायमंड इट्स वन हार्डनेस एंड इट्स बिकॉज ऑफ रिजिड स्ट्रक्चर इट इज सो मच लाइक आयनिक कंपाउंड. सो दैट इज द रीजन hardness and crystalline structure. Crystal jaise dikhta hai. It's so hard that it's almost like a crystal. It is a crystal, in fact. So it's a crystalline structure. Okay. And because of that layers, like because of the slippery layers of graphite, so we say like graphite is not hard, it is soft. It's soft and slippery. And that gives rise to like slippery layers ki wajah se the softness of graphite comes into picture. And yeah, so the structure, like if diamond is crystalline, the opposite of crystalline is amorphous. Amorphous is like what do you call it? Not anisotropy. So amorphous is, you know, the it's soft. It's like it's the stark opposite of crystalline. Like if table salt is crystalline, your paste and you know your sulfur powder, like all of that is amorphous structure. Next, abhi diamond and graphite, based on the structure, does diamond have free electrons?
No.
No, ma'am.
Which means, no free electrons, or graphite ke case mein, you do have some, like some free electrons. So because of that, और कौन से प्रॉपर्टी में डिफरेंस होगा डायमंड वर्सेस ग्रेफाइट?
इलेक्ट्रिक कंडक्टिविटी,
कंडक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी.
करेक्ट. सो दैट मेक्स ग्रेफाइट अ कंडक्टर, इलेक्ट्रिक कंडक्टर. एंड डायमंड इज अ नॉट, इट डज नॉट कंडक्ट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. और क्या, व्हाट एल्स कैन वी टॉक अबाउट? These are the main things. Extra property of diamond that comes in because of crystalline structure is the luster. Okay, so diamond has that shine. It has got that refractive index because, you know, it's pretty crystalline and optical properties usse aa rahe. And graphite also has a luster, but its luster is more like abhi car bonnet pe you have that shine, right? It's not transparent. It does not like refract or reflect light. Graphite has a different kind of luster. In fact, you guys, like you guys would have pencils, no? You can observe ki, you can see that, you know, the light is being reflected off of it. See if there's a bigger lead that I can show. So I don't know how visible it is because it's so tiny. But yeah, like pencil hoga na, like just pick a pencil, observe this graphite color stuff. Yeah. But yeah, main uses of diamond and graphite comes from these properties. So some use you already know. Ananya is asking, does graphite conduct heat? It does conduct, like not as well as metals, but it's not like a complete insulator like rubber or something. Like it does conduct to some extent. Yeah. All right. So diamond, because of its hardness, what is it used as? So like in your books, you can write under uses, like yahan pe what we discussed was properties. Next section you can write it as uses, but if you have the space you can write it by the property also. So because of diamond's hardness, what will it be used as?
Cutting other substances.
Yes. There is a famous saying also, right? Any of you know? Like, diamond can cut only diamond. Have you guys heard of that?
Yeah, ma'am.
Yeah.
Yeah, diamond can cut only diamonds. The Hindi version, I don't know. I don't remember.
Loha something.
Loha to iron hai na.
Diamond. Hira ko katta or something like that.
Yes, something like that. Yeah. So it's used in like cutting hard things. Mansi has sent crystalline structure because it refracts light and all that. It's used in making jewelry, ornaments, like decorative purposes. So jewels and decoration. Graphite, because it is soft and slippery, iska use
kahan pe? Lubricant.
Yes, graphite is used as a lubricant. Yeah. So wherever you have moving parts, like fan rotate hota hai. So it has something called ball bearings. Jo, that help in like rotating. So over time, if like metal and metal rub against each other, sparks produce ho sakte, the metal will get wore down. So to prevent all of this, add some lubricant there. Like that's just an example, but yeah, a lot of places where lubricants are required, make it smooth, you have graphite. Conductivity. This is something that you guys have seen. Hint is electrolysis. Yes.
Electrodes.
Graphite. Like electrodes made of graphite. So if you want like relatively inert electrodes, like something that can conduct electricity, but should not take part in the reaction, like jo bhi solution mein ho raha hai. So you can't take metal because displacement reaction ho sakta hai. Like it can disturb the reaction. So in that case, graphite is preferred. And graphite also because, you know, it's carbon to available hai. So it's relatively cheap compared to platinum or any other material you might think of. Yeah. And soft and slippery ek hai lubricant. Another use is because the layers can slip away easily, you use as lead in pencils. Yeah. The pencil make writing jacket. In fact, there's a video on YouTube also. It's more like a fun thing, not like a serious thing. So combining these two properties, right? People have made paper circuits. So paper pe hi attach like LED bulbs and then take a pencil which is really, really dark, which has a high graphite content. So if you want to form a circuit, electrical circuit, there's a very cute, fun video also making use of this. I'll try to search it. I'll send it to you guys on the group if I find it. Again, that's again, you know, research in the starting stages, which serious is an idea. For fun, people have done it.
Ma'am, there was this trend on the internet, like microwaving graphite and then finding diamonds. Like it was there and people used to try it.
I don't find that hard to believe.
Yeah, ma'am, like it's not true, but there were like a lot of videos regarding that thing.
Nahin, diamond form karne mein, it takes like you need extreme amount of temperature and pressure, like aise microwave se nahin hota hai. Okay, so let me know once you guys are done noting this. Is there any other information about graphites, about graphite and diamond? That's it. We discussed properties, structure, and uses. Okay, cool. Oh, another obvious thing that we actually did not tell out loud. What does it look like, diamond? Like, what is the visual glass. Difference between diamond and graphite? Yeah. Instead of saying glass.
Opaque and transparent.
Yes. So this is transparent. Transparent and bright. Crystal, yes, literally. And graphite is black and opaque. So there's a word that you use to describe the different forms of the same thing. So diamond, graphite, like all of these, Buckminster fullerene, all of these are called allotropes of carbon. So allotropes is a word used for any element that exists in different forms. Like in different forms, matlab, we're not talking about compounds and all. They're all pure elements only, just that because of the difference in structure, they have different properties. Like diamond and graphite are allotropes of carbon. Vaise hi sulfur ka bhi, there are like two or three allotropes. You have alpha sulfur, beta sulfur. Phosphorus ka, you have allotropes.
Ma'am?
Red phosphorus, white phosphorus. Yeah?
After this, can you just show the dot structure for sulfur, S8 molecule?
Yeah. Dot structures are difficult, hoga, but I can show you like the structure.
Because we had done it in class today, like it was like a round circle. But in that, how do we maintain pairs of electrons?
Theek hai. I'll show that, yes. I will do that. Okay. But yeah, so overall general word that you use to describe अगर एक ही एलिमेंट मल्टीपल फॉर्म्स में है सो दोज फॉर्म्स आर कॉल्ड एलोट्रोप्स. इफ वी हैव टू डिस्कस द एग्जैक्ट डेफिनेशन, या वंस यू गाइस आर डन विद दिस आई विल टेक द डेफिनेशन फ्रॉम द चैप्टर नोट्स. आई विल पोस्ट इट हियर. Okay. Mansi, Alina, Jaden, Ananya, Bhavika, Aditya, Anirban. Okay. Puneet, Abhishek, Jaden. Sarah, Rohan.
Can you repeat once again about allotropes?
I'll show the definition like once I can switch from the screen.
Okay.
Okay. So Ryan, Amay, Ritvik, Divya, have not heard from you guys. Neil also has not reached yet. Neil Prajapati. Snehal also. Yeah. I've not seen your name also, Snehal. Okay, I'll wait for like a minute and then I'm going to switch. Yeah.
Ma'am?
Yeah?
Ma'am, where else is graphite used as a lubricant?
Like specific places, I'll have to look in. I can't think of anything abhi like at the moment. Mostly like the example that I gave you, mostly machine parts may it'll be used. They say fans may ball bearings. In general, like factory machines and all, where you have moving parts, like rotating parts, like where the like gears and all, where you know two surfaces have to rub against each other. Those kind of places it's used as this thing. As a general thing, you can think of it as machinery. Like household substances, I don't find it. Maybe grease is like a form of graphite because that's also like black and slippery and all that, right? So cycle mein kala kala grease hota hai na. That could be like a, it's not direct graphite, but like graphite along with the oil and you know, it's a derivative of it, mixture of something. Yeah. So if you find that, you know, there's some kind of oily thing being used, and if it's also like black in color, you can bet that, yeah, maybe this contains graphite. Okay. So definition of allotropes is right here. So allotropes are like two or more different physical forms in which an element can exist. So this is important. So a key element, if it exists in two or more different forms, and it needs to be physical forms. So we're not talking about chemical forms, we're not talking about compounds and all. Pure element, if it exists in different physical forms. So those forms are called allotropes. So the two or more different physical forms in which an element can exist is called us element ke different allotropes. So each form, like diamond is an allotrope, graphite is an allotrope of carbon. वैसे ही sulfur के अपने allotropes होते हैं, phosphorus के अपने allotropes होते हैं. Let's see if anyone can figure out the allotropes of oxygen.
Ozone.
Very nice. The general O2 gas that you breathe in, that is one allotrope, and ozone is the other allotrope. Good. Yeah. So it's there in your chapter notes. You can note it down. Learn that. It's just the different forms. That phenomenon is called allotropy. Each of those forms are called allotropes. Okay.
Ma'am?
Yeah.
Ma'am, what is the difference between covalent bond and covalency?
Oh, they're the same thing. So it's written right here, right? That bond is called covalent bond. And how many bonds are formed? Matlab, how many electron pairs are shared? That's called covalency. Huh. The number of shared electron pairs between two atoms to complete their octet is known as covalency. Like carbon, को चार बॉन्ड बनाना पड़ेगा. सो बेसिकली कार्बन इन एनी कंपाउंड विल हैव लाइक फोर शेयर्ड पेयर्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. सो कोवैलेंसी ऑफ कार्बन इन दैट कंपाउंड इज फोर. लाइक कितने पेयर्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स शेयर हो रहे, दैट इज कोवैलेंसी. ऑक्सीजन का कोवैलेंसी इज टू, क्योंकि इफ यू टेक ऑक्सीजन मॉलिक्यूल देर आर टू पेयर्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स दैट आर शेयर्ड. Water may be oxygen is sharing two pairs of electrons with hydrogen. So covalency is two. Okay. So we've discussed the structure and properties and uses of different allotropes of carbon. So these are like the physical forms of carbon. If you take pure carbon, like how does it exist? Where is it used? All of those things. Now coming to the chemical nature of carbon. To talk about chemical nature, we need to talk about the electronic configuration. So carbon, jiska atomic number is 6, iska electronic configuration kya hoga?
2-4.
Yeah.
2-4.
And based on the electronic configuration, iska valency kya hai?
Four.
Carbon needs to form four covalent bonds in any compound. Like that's what it does to gain that stable octet configuration. Okay. Why it forms only covalent bonds? We had discussed in the previous class. Because cation, anion, nahi form kar sakta. It's either unstable or it's
high energy required.
Energy. Yes, high energy required. So carbon is happy with four covalent bonds. So using these four covalent bonds, carbon forms like a really, really large number of compounds. Okay. The main thing about carbon is it forms like carbon, like you call this kind of thing versatile. Carbon is so versatile. Have you guys heard of this word versatile before in any other context?
Use camphor.
Huh?
Evaporation.
That is volatile.
Yeah.
That's volatile. So versatile, it's a normal English word only. You can use this word to describe a person also. Like if you have any person.
All rounder.
Yes, exactly. So who is very good at so many different things. They're good with, you know, like art, performing arts, singing, dancing, but they're also good in studies. They're also good in like quizzing. So that person is versatile nature. Like movies mein bhi hota hai na, versatile actor. Ye to horror movies mein bhi act karta hai, comedy mein bhi achha hai, romantic mein bhi achha hai. Like versatile actor, many different roles. So coming to carbon, we call carbon, adapting easily. So coming to carbon, we call it versatile because it forms a lot of compounds. It forms any type of compound as long as it's four valencies, as long as the covalency four is met, carbon will form a bond. Okay. So versatile nature is because of two major characteristics of carbon. Okay. So one is called catenation. Like kyun aisa hai carbon compared to like any other molecule? Because of one, catenation, and two, because of tetravalency. Okay. So let's take each thing one by one. What do you mean by catenation? So this is a new word. What kind of understanding do you have? Like, if you've already done it in school, like, what do you understand by catenation? No? Okay.
Ma'am, it is like the structure, like, it can form in a ring structure, in like a branch structure, or in like a straight line, or something like that.
Close. Yes, it is related to that. The main point is, so catenation is the capability to form self-linked chains. So self-linked is an important point. So self-linked chains. Okay. So self-linked ka matlab, like what we're talking about is, so carbon can form really long chains. And as Alina said, so those chains can be branched, it can be ringed, it can be like straight chains. So any kind of structure by bonding to its own self. So all these carbon atoms will line up and it can form this kind of a structure, or it can form like this kind of a structure where you have branched chains. Or you also find like ring structure of carbon and any number of ring, like minimum 3 ring ka ho sakta hai, 5 ring ka ho sakta, like 5 atoms ke saath ho sakta hai. You also find 7 ring structure of carbon. Okay. So that way carbon is capable of forming long self-linked chains. So that probability, like that capability, is called catenation. Yeah. So exact definition, again, like proper words, I'll display it, note it down. The property of self-linking of atoms of elements like carbon. So it's a general property. Okay, so carbon has that property, isliye we are learning it here, but it is applied to any element that is capable of it. So it's a capability, the property of self-linking of atoms through covalent bonds to form long, straight or branched chains and rings of different sizes is called catenation. Yeah. So catenation is the property. One, self-linking of atoms hona chahiye. So the same atom is bonded to each other. Like you have all these chains made of carbon only. Okay. So self-linking of the property of self-linking of atoms of elements like carbon. And they are all linked by covalent bonds. Like all of these are covalent bonds. Yahan pe examples I showed are single bonds only, but you will come across double bonds also. So they're all linked by covalent bonds, mostly single bonds, double bonds, triple bonds also. I'm sure it exists. But yeah, this is the thing. To form long, straight or branched chains, it can form like straight chains or branched chains or like ring structures of different sizes. Yeah. So catenation may, there's 4 points. I'll just erase this so that I can write it down. So catenation is the property of forming property of self-linking is important. Like same atoms are all bonded to each other. What kind of bonds? By covalent bonds. Self-linking of atoms by covalent bonds to form. So oxygen, double bond oxygen, again, self-link hai, covalent hai, but this is not catenation. So catenation is when it forms either straight or branched chains and rings of different sizes. So that is called catenation. In fact, catenation is really, really important. It's an important property of carbon, and catenation is the whole reason that life exists. See, life is made of cells, and cells is made of, you have membranes, you have DNA and all of that, right? And at the base, like even if you go deeper than that, what is DNA? It's again like a long chain of carbon, right? Even a membrane, it's a long chain of, you know, carbon, along with, of course, hydrogen, oxygen, and all of that. But the backbone of it is all carbon. Even if I take a strand of hair, like hair is, you know, these are dead cells, but still cells are formed of something, right? So long fibrous chain of carbon. So the property of catenation is really important, and it is the reason, you know, because carbon is able to catenate, that's the reason it is versatile. It's able to form a lot of different types of compounds. Like 6 carbons ke saath ek chain form ho sakta hai, 8 carbon ke saath ek chain form ho sakta hai. Now both of those compounds are completely different. Fir agar 7 carbons ke saath if you form a chain, that's again yet another different. 4 carbons ke saath if you form a chain, that's another carbon compound. Yeah. So the property of self-linking of atoms by covalent bonds to form straight or branch chains and rings of different sizes. So that's called catenation. And another property, the second property that I had mentioned, was tetravalency. What do you mean by tetravalency? Like, it's right there in the name.
Tetra is four.
Having a valency of four.
Absolutely. So carbon has valency of four, which means that carbon is able to bond in four different ways. Like, carbon needs to have four bonds, basically, not four different ways. So in this also, it is pretty versatile. Charo single bond bana sakta hai. Ya to fir it can form, you know, one double bond and two single bonds, or it can form one triple bond and one single bond. Like, all of these are possible with carbon. And by using a permutation combination, like, pick any of these bonds, arrange them in any order, and you'll get like different compounds with carbon. And tetravalency fulfill karne ke liye, carbon is not choosy at all. So either it will bond with its own self, or it will bond with like hydrogen. It also has the capability of bonding with oxygen. It can also bond with like nitrogen. It can also bond with sulfur. Like, whatever is ready to form a covalent bond, carbon will form a covalent bond with that. So it'll form bonds with chlorine. Like, that's why you have chloroform and all that. Pure carbon and hydrogens, you have your like whatever gas term, natural gas, you have there, petrol, all of those are hydrocarbons, just hydrogen and carbon. So yeah. So if carbon is not choosy at all, if it's able to form a covalent bond with any atom that is ready to share electrons, and second, carbon is capable of forming like really, really long chains, both these properties put together, what you have is a result of so many different compounds of carbon. That's the whole reason why organic chemistry is a whole different branch of chemistry itself, and why it needs to be studied in a completely different way. Yeah. So two main important properties of carbon: catenation, tetravalency. Tetravalency is pretty easy. Tetra is four. Valency is the valency, kitne bonds form karta hai. So because carbon is capable of forming covalent bonds, four covalent bonds, it's not picky or choosy about how it fulfills the four valencies. It can form a bond with any other atom. And catenation, property of self-linking by covalent bonds to form straight or branch chains, rings of different sizes. So basically, carbon bonds in any way that it can, and it forms like all these different types of structures. And every little minor change in the structure will give you a different compound. So that's another reason why you have a large number of carbon compounds. Okay. So very, very few elements in the periodic table have this property. Obviously, agar valency chota hai, like if you're talking about chlorine, chlorine ka valency kya hai?
One.
Chlorine ka valency is only one, right? So if one valency of chlorine is fulfilled by something here, this is not O, like let's say it's fulfilled by something here, will chlorine be capable of forming like chains? So agar kuch chain form karna hai, to
no, it will just take electron.
Yeah, it's just at the corner, and yahan pe jo bhi bond hua, that's the end of it, right? So the happy coincidence that carbon has a big enough valency, and another factor for catenation is size of the atom is pretty important. So if it's a really large atom we're talking about, एक तो कोवेलेंट बॉन्ड फॉर्म करने का कैपेबिलिटी कम होगा बिकॉज द न्यूक्लियस कांट होल्ड ऑन टू द शेयर्ड पेयर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स एंड ऑल दैट. सो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट लाइक इफ द बॉन्ड इज वीक इट कैन ब्रेक इजिली. तो वो कॉम्पाउंड इट विल बी फेयरली अनस्टेबल. Like a tiny bit of heat or put it in water or do anything to it, it's going to break easily. But carbon, it's a very tiny atom. Like small size of carbon is also a good, factor in ensuring that it forms like strong bonds and it can form like a whole chain of it. So carbon is one atom that we know that it forms like long chains. Another element that shows catenation is silicon. So carbon and silicon show like the maximum extent of catenation in the whole periodic table. Metals though don't form covalent bonds only, so those will be taken out of the equation completely. Yeah. So because of this, we have many different compounds of carbon. And the way we study compounds of carbon, if there are a large amount of things, is to classify them. Okay. Biome, the way you classify it, birds is a different category. Insects are a different category. Crustaceans are a different category. Fishes are a different category. That way, organic chemistry may be, you have different categories of compounds. Okay. So how do you decide कौन से कैटेगरीज कैसे कैटेगराइज करना चाहिए? दैट ऑल डिपेंड्स ऑन क्या क्या एटम्स है उस कॉम्पाउंड में. ओके ओके. सो बिफोर आई स्टार्ट ऑफ विद दिस, लेट्स सी व्हाट ऑल एलिमेंट्स कार्बन कैन फॉर्म अ बॉन्ड विथ. सो कार्बन कैन बॉन्ड विथ, pretty easy to narrow down kis kis compounds ke sath carbon bond kar sakta hai. Your big hint is carbon can form only covalent bonds. Okay. Between 1 to 20 elements, what all non-metals do you know of?
Oxygen.
Hydrogen.
Hydrogen. Hydrogen, yes.
Nitrogen.
Nitrogen.
Yes, I'll write it here only. So there's
chlorine, hydrogen,
there's oxygen, there's
chlorine,
sulfur,
hydrogen, chlorine, chlorine,
sulfur. Anything else?
Chlorine.
Chlorine. Let's see. Hydrogen likh liya. Helium is inert. Lithium, beryllium, boron to like metal metalloid. They won't form covalent. Boron ke baad aayega carbon, which is what we're talking about. Carbon ke baad you have nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine. Neon is in
and phosphorus.
Phosphorus is one, yes. Neon, magnesium, aluminium, sodium, ignore. Silicon is one, but silicon also is fairly like again four bonds. Sure, like silicon, SiC is a compound that's a, silicon carbide is another really hard substance like diamond. Silicon ke baad you have phosphorus, sulfur. Sulfur ke baad you have chlorine. Uske baad inert gases and metals. So let's ignore. That's it. So as you go, as you increase the atomic number 20 ke beyond, all you find would be like majority of them are metals. So apart from this, other two substances are you have bromine and iodine. Okay. So depending on which atom carbon has bonded with, you can categorize them in into different this thing. Okay. So one group of compounds that you have are called hydrocarbons. Okay, so looking at the name, can you guess hydrocarbons ka meaning kya hai?
Hydrogen and carbon.
Only hydrogen.
Hydrogen, carbon,
That's it. Hydrogen and carbon. So these are compounds containing only hydrogen and carbon. Okay. So none of the others, just hydrogen. So just hydrogen and carbon. Okay. Can you guess, like, if I were to make a compound with single carbon and single hydrogen, simplest compound, what can you think of? Like, what will be the structure of this compound?
CH4.
There you go.
Methane.
Methane, yes. So, ek carbon diya maine. So, carbon ka valency hai 4. It needs to bond with 4 different things. Dusra atom, mere paas hydrogen hi hai. हाइड्रोजन का वैलेंसी क्या है?
One.
तो फिल हाइड्रोजन एट ईच एंड. सो दिस यू गेट CH4. सो वन कार्बन एंड 4 हाइड्रोजन. सो दिस पर्टिकुलर कॉम्पाउंड इज कॉल्ड मीथेन. नेक्स्ट, अभी हमने लाइक वी जस्ट स्टडीड कैटिनेशन, मतलब इट कैन फॉर्म chains, rings of different sizes. So let's increase the chain by 1. Pehle ek carbon tha, now I'm taking 2 carbons. Again, carbon ka valency 4 hai. Now this carbon is already bonded to one more carbon here, which means that it only needs 3 more hydrogens to fill, third, fourth. Same is with this carbon, iska valency hai 4. One is already satisfied by this carbon. So second, third, fourth will be the remaining hydrogens. So iska molecular formula hoga. Count how many carbons and how many hydrogens.
C2H6.
Yeah, C2. So 2 carbons, H6. We also said ki carbon is capable of forming single bond, double bond and triple bond. Right. So instead of single bond, what if carbon has a double bond? So how many more hydrogens will be required to complete the valency is carbon ka? Carbon ka total valency kitna hai?
4
mein se how many has carbon completed is double bond ke saath?
2 to 6.
2 is already done, right? Matlab
I'm not getting
4 are required.
2 more are required.
2 more are
required. For each.
Yes, for each. Okay. So carbon ka valency hai 4. Usme se carbon has already bonded, like if I'm taking double bond, 1 and 2. Char mein se do to already share ho gaye. So remaining 2 hai. Okay. So that's what I've drawn here. So fill the rest of the valencies with hydrogen. Okay. Now iska molecular formula kya hoga? How many carbons and how many hydrogens? Count and tell me.
C2
and C4.
Yes, C2 and there are 4 H's. Yeah. Anirvan, what part did you not understand?
After you told me there is two carbons from that.
I'll draw it again. So, yes. Maine 2 carbon atom liya. So, 2 carbon atom ke beech mein सिंगल बॉन्ड हो सकता है या तो फिर डबल बॉन्ड हो सकता है या फिर ट्रिपल बॉन्ड हो सकता है. राइट, कार्बन कैन फॉर्म सिंगल, डबल, ट्रिपल, ऑल 3 टाइप्स ऑफ बॉन्ड्स. सो नाउ वी आर जस्ट ट्राइंग टू फिगर आउट कि इन ईच ऑफ दीज केसेस किस तरह का कॉम्पाउंड बना सकते हैं हम विथ जस्ट कार्बन एंड हाइड्रोजन. तो अगर सिंगल बॉन्ड है तो हाउ मेनी हाइड्रोजन आर रिक्वायर्ड टू मेक कार्बन स्टेबल, मतलब वैलेंसी फोर पूरा करने के लिए? कार्बन को टोटल कितना चाहिए लाइक वैलेंसी स्टेबल करने के लिए?
फोर
ना. सो नाउ फोकस ऑन दिस कार्बन अलोन, द वन दैट आई सर्कल्ड. फोर में से हाउ मेनी बॉन्ड्स डिड इट ऑलरेडी कंप्लीट फॉर्मिंग?
वन
करेक्ट. ये वाला बॉन्ड ये कार्बन के साथ फॉर्म किया, सो दैट्स डन. सो चार में से एक कंप्लीट हो गया, तो रिमेनिंग और कितना चाहिए?
थ्री.
सो द रिमेनिंग बॉन्ड्स विल बी फुलफिल्ड बाय हाइड्रोजन. सिमिलरली ये वाला कार्बन के लिए हाउ मेनी हाइड्रोजन्स डू यू नीड फुलफिल करने के लिए?
Three.
So use the same logic. तो इधर आते हैं. So now focus on this carbon. चार में से कितने bonds form कर चुका है ये वाला carbon?
Three.
Where are you seeing three?
Only one.
नहीं, like what type of a bond is this?
It's double bond.
Double bond ना? Double bond, like focus on the word double. Double मतलब it has already formed two bonds with this carbon. So दो electrons already share कर चुका है, so it received two more electrons. So चार में से two bonds it has already done with this carbon. तो remaining और कितने bonds form करने हैं इसको?
More two.
More, yes. What about this carbon?
And this is also more two.
Two. There you go. Yeah. So remaining whatever is pending, fill it up with hydrogen. Now coming to this, इसको ये वाले molecule को complete करने के लिए how many hydrogens are required?
One.
And three. One.
One overall.
One for each.
Correct. So triple bond form कर चुका है. So the fourth one, single hydrogen are required. So this is forming C2H6. इसका formula होगा C2H4. इसका formula होगा C2H2. Okay. Now you can see that even though the length of the chain is same, and the elements forming them, like jo atoms le rahe hum, they are all made of only carbon and hydrogen only, and all of them contain two carbons each, but they are all completely different compounds. Ek mein sare single bonds hai, dusre mein ek double bond hai, teesra wala mein there is a triple bond, right? So within hydrocarbons, you can classify them further. So within hydrocarbons, there are three types of hydrocarbons, jiska single bonds akela hai, fir the ones that have double bonds, and the ones that have triple bonds. Yeah. So jiska khali single bonds hi hai, they are called alkanes. I'll just highlight it. Alkanes. Spelling you need to know carefully because that's where the difference is. Alkanes, A-N-E-S. So this is just single bond. Single bond between carbons. Okay. Phir jiska double bond hai, so those type of compounds are called alkenes. A-N-E-S, this is E-N-E-S. So be very careful with the spelling. And this compound mein triple bond hai between the carbon atoms. They are called alkynes.
Alkynes.
alkynes, Y-N-E-S. Okay, so hydrocarbons, they contain only C and H, like carbon and Hobbs, carbon and hydrogen. Or carbon, like hydrogen to ek bond hi bana sakta hai, but carbon can form single, double, triple, right? So depending on what type of bond you find, if it contains only single bonds, then it is alkanes. If it contains like minimum one double bond, it's called alkenes. And if it contains minimum one triple bond, they're called alkynes. Okay, now within this, so alkenes and alkynes, jo bhi hydrocarbons mein multiple bonds hai, double and triple, so those type of compounds are called unsaturated hydrocarbons. And just may you have only single bonds, they are called saturated hydrocarbons. Okay. So why are they called this? We'll discuss. Where have you guys heard the word unsaturated, saturated pehle?
Solutions.
So generally, like if I talk about saturated, unsaturated, what kind of meaning comes to your mind? Like, what do these words mean? Saturated hona or unsaturated hona? Anyone?
Like unsaturated means, you know, you can make more.
Yes.
Bonds.
And saturated meaning?
It's full, you can't make anymore.
Very good, yes. Saturated matlab full ho gaya, like there's nothing more you can do. Like if I'm talking about solution, saturated matlab maximum extent jitna ho sakta hai utna ho gaya. Solution matlab solute dalna. If you're talking about studies, like dimag saturate ho gaya matlab, nothing else is going in your brain, like I can't study anymore. Right? So saturated matlab complete, unsaturated matlab more can go in. So when we talk about hydrocarbons, saturated, unsaturated, you can think of it as, can I break any bonds in this? Think of it in that direction. Okay. So agar double triple bond hai na, I can still break this bond and have the same number of carbon atoms, just wo double ko single bana diya. Same with triple bond. I can break one or two of the bonds and I can still have a compound with same number of carbon atoms. But agar single bond ko, agar us bond ko maine break kar liya, then it won't be that compound anymore. Like pura, it would have broken into two parts. It won't be a two member carbon compound anymore, right? So that's the maximum extent to which you can break the bonds. So you can, you know, just for remembering saturated, unsaturated, you can think of it as, can I have the same number of carbon atoms even after breaking the bonds? So double or triple may, you can convert those double, triple into single bond by breaking like this half of it, or, you know, one or two bonds in this. But saturated may, if I break any bond, it is going to break the compound itself. It won't be the same number of carbon atoms anymore. So you can think of it for, you know, remembering what is the difference between saturated and unsaturated. So alkenes and alkynes, are unsaturated hydrocarbons and alkanes are saturated hydrocarbons. Okay. Have you guys heard of this difference saturated, unsaturated in context of like health or cooking or something like that? Like, have you come across saturated fats, unsaturated fats, something like that?
I've heard about it.
Paper, right? Yeah. So that meaning also, it basically, the basic is from here. So if you're talking about saturated fats, is uska matlab hai that particular fatty acid, jo bhi that particular compound is making up that fat. It means that that particular fat has like a double bond in it, like a double bond or triple bond in it. And if I'm talking about saturated, matlab only single bonds are there. And if I'm talking about unsaturated fats, it means that those fats have like a double or triple bond in them. That way. Puneet is asking, can you explain again why unsaturated, saturated is used here? Again, so the technical definition is how many more hydrogens can you add to it? Unsaturated mena, if I want to add hydrogen atoms, I can still break these bonds and add hydrogens here. But in the case of saturated, if I break this bond, I'm going to get two separate carbon atoms. Like if I have like a five-membered carbon, wherever I break, I'm going to get like a 2+3. Right? It's not a five-membered ring anymore. But unsaturated ke case mein, suppose I have a double bond over here. I can like break this bond and add hydrogens and still have the same number of carbon atoms. Even in the case of triple bond, suppose I have a 5-carbon atom wala triple bonded molecule. I can like break one or two bonds. Two options. Ek bond break kar sakti hu, do bond break kar sakti hu, and I can add more hydrogens here. It, this particular molecule can take more hydrogens. But a single bonded thing, if I want to add hydrogens, there is no place because all of them are single bonds only. So it's like saturated with hydrogens. These molecules can take more hydrogens. So they're unsaturated. That's where the word saturated, unsaturated applies here. The main thing is, can I give it, like, can that molecule take more hydrogen atoms or not?
So saturated cannot be broken easily, right?
No, cannot be broken easily. Okay, unsaturated ke case mein, this double bond, triple bond centers are like fairly reactive centers. You can like add other molecules there. Okay. Puneet, does that make sense?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, but in saturated one, why don't we add hydrogen there?
No, like saturated, matlab sare single bonds hai na. One thing keep in mind about organic chemistry is carbon ka valency hamesha fulfill hona chahiye. So even when I just simply mention the carbons, in your mind, by default, whatever valencies are not mentioned, it means that that is filled with hydrogens only. Okay. It's not that it's incomplete. Yeah. So if I just draw something like this, so whatever incomplete valencies are there, like is carbon mein do are incomplete, right? So that's filled with hydrogens. Isme ek double bond hai, ek chlorine hai. So this is filled with a hydrogen here. So the default, like hydrogen is basically a filler organic compounds mein. Yeah. So yeah, so saturated mein, all of it is single bonds. You can't add any more hydrogens. Unsaturated mein, you can break the double bond and add more hydrogens while still retaining that exact number of carbon atoms. So because you can add more, you call it unsaturated. So your saturated fat, unsaturated fat also is because of this definition. Saturated fat mein, wo particular fat molecule mein sare single bonds hi hai. Unsaturated fat mein, there are double bonds or triple bonds in that. So that's where your difference of saturated compounds, unsaturated compounds comes from. Okay. It's almost 5. I think this is a logical place to stop because if we start, kafi sara hai. So we'll talk about the differences between saturated, unsaturated, and the general properties of alkanes. Unka, yeah, the general formula and kis tarah ke, like reactions, not in detail, but some reactions and isomerism, like nomenclature, structure, use of chalu jayega. So I think we'll stop here. Organic chemistry, I want to take it slightly slow because a completely new topic. And abhi priority bhi nahi hai.